So now we are going to study about job analysis. This is another topic in compensation management. It is a very important topic because job analysis is conducted by the human resource department and the results are used for various purposes besides setting the compensation of the employees. So the job analysis actually is done and it can be used to decide about the structure of the organization, the organizational structure. So the organizational structure can be determined in two ways. One is the job based and the other one is the person based. That means using the skills and the competences of the employees. So in this topic, we are going to focus on the job based approach of setting the organization structure. So what does job-based means? Job-based approach means determining the skills and the knowledge that are required to do the job. So basically identifying the similarities and the differences in the work based on this information. So this part talks about why do we do job analysis. So job analysis can be done and the results can be used for compensation, for recruitment, for hiring, for all these purposes, for training purposes. So this is an example of a job description of a registered nurse. So we have the job title. Then the other common elements of the job descriptions are the job summary, the relationship, that means to whom the person reports, who reports to that person, these things. Then the qualifications that are required and the responsibilities. Qualifications are actually part of the job specification. So when we do the job analysis, we get the job descriptions, and based on the job description, we do an evaluation of the job, and then we determine the structure of the organization based on the job evaluation. So we are going to cover job evaluation in the next topic. So job analysis can be done using different processes. We have some terms over here, like first one is task. So task is the basic thing that a person does. For example, for a customer support representative, the tasks would include receiving calls, answering the questions of the customers, and solving their problems. So combining similar tasks like this would make up the job of the customer support representative. And combining similar jobs like this would lead to the job family. So the types of information that are collected, we will talk about that. So before that, this is the conventional job analysis process. So first we determine the job information, what type of information we would like to collect. Then we visit the job site. Then we conduct interviews of the people who are doing the job. Then we might again visit the job site for some clarification. And then we consolidate the information. And finally, we draft the job description and the specification. And these are then verified with the line manager and the management. So the job information that is collected includes things like the job identification information, job content, then characteristics of the employee who is doing the job, the relationships, all this information. So the job data is collected. This information are collected. So this is an example of the questionnaire that we use. So we collect the information in two ways. One is the conventional method. That means here the job analyst asks questions, asks the job holder questions, basically interviews the job holder. And by using that information, the job analyst can create the job description and the specification. Another method is the quantitative method. So under this method, the job analyst usually collects information by giving a questionnaire to the job holder. The information can be collected by the job analyst or it could be done by the line manager. The line manager also provides information. And if there is any discrepancy, then that is referred to the higher authority of the management. We have an example of a job description for a nurse manager. So the job description needs to be verified finally. So the job analysis is judged using certain criteria. One is known as reliability. That means the job analysis that we have done, if we do the same analysis later after a few days, will it give the same results or not? Does it have validity? That means using the job analysis, if we do the job analysis, then does it capture the accurate information or not? That is, the person that is doing the job, is his or her responsibilities captured or not? Is it acceptable by the job holders and the stakeholders or not? And does it fulfill the purpose of the job analysis? That is, can we use the job description and the specifications to hire people properly or not?